Hello friends, welcome to Data Pandit. Today we are going to discuss about a data warehousing load scenario wherein we have to load the huge dimension table on daily basis. And if you do not know about the database or data warehousing pipeline, particularly data warehousing pipeline, so what happens is that we source the data from different source systems, maybe the flat files or maybe just some inputs, and you know, maybe the some OLTP database systems, you know, or maybe the mainframe systems we have in at the source side, and maybe Salesforce or you know, even the, you know, S3 bucket or AWS, you know, or the cloud solutions, cloud storage. Okay, so we get the data on daily basis, and we validate the data, and we apply some, you know, and data enrichment and, you know, lookups and those transformation logic and prepare the data for the data warehousing load or database load. So before loading into the database or data warehousing, we prepare the load ready files, which will be, you know, equivalent in structure with the database or data warehouse, and then we probably load the landing zone first and then the staging table, landing zone or a staging table, staging tables or landing tables, right? So it depends upon, you know, the design or depending upon the particular use case or a particular, you know, project. It happens, and then the dimension load happens, and then the fact load happens after that. Okay, then there will be a reporting solution on top of that, or maybe BI, business intelligence reporting, right? So Power BI or probably the Tableau or Cognos reporting, and so on. Okay, so this is a high level data pipeline for the data warehousing projects, and let's talk about the one piece of it, which is a dimension table load. And we will talk about the SD type kind of dimension table load today. We will take up the SD type 2 in some other occasion. And today, so whenever the SD type 2 dimension load we need to do, and particularly when the database table is huge and we don't want to unload that, you know, table before getting, before, you know, our upset logic, right? And we need to find out the insert and update record and then load into the dimension table. So the main feature of this scenario is a database table is huge, and we are not, you know, allowed or asked to unload that much huge dimension table on daily basis. So let's see how we are going to solve this scenario using you know, our graph or ab initio, you know, how we are going to employ our potential and logical capabilities to solve this issue, okay, or solve this use case. So normally, the obvious solution comes in mind is we get the two sources, which is our current flow, today's data coming in from the different sources, and, you know, refined and validated data, and then we have yesterday's copy or maybe the current data warehousing copy of the dimension, and then unload the dimension table and join with the today's file, and we are getting the updated and inserted record in today's, you know, and we gather those data and put into the update table, and update table will be updating or inserting the date dimension table, and that table will be used in tomorrow's unload. Okay, and then the same thing happens as and when the entire data warehousing process runs. Okay, so in this scenario, this is a very, very obvious solution, and yeah, it's going to work. It's going to work. Okay, but when our database table, your dimension table is used, and we will have, you know, face the problem while unloading the data on daily basis, right? So it's a huge table, and, you know, downloading the data from database, and then we have update is, we cannot ignore it, but we certainly can ignore the unload on daily basis, right? So what we are going to do to avoid the unload on daily basis, right? So what we are going to do is, I mean, let's see the first solution, how we are going to achieve this. What we are going to do is, we will join the master. So we are going to maintain the master file in our file system, because this is one obvious solution. the local solution, right? Okay. So otherwise, we can, if we have, you know, data mart or data warehouse, right? So we could place that records in maybe data mart, and then, you know, data mart unload, if it is easy to do the unload from the data mart rather than doing from the data warehouse, right? So those can be thought out alternate processes. But now, let's say, I mean, we have a, we need to maintain the master copy every day, which should be as equal to as, you know, dimension table, which is sitting in the database. So we are going to avoid the one-off data unload on daily basis. So what we are going to do, we are joining the master copy with the current data, and then similarly, I mean, we are going to get the, you know, upsert and insert and, you know, everything. So, okay, and update is coming from the, you know, output port, and you know, the new record is going to come from the unused one. Okay, and from unused zero, whatever is coming from unused zero is what. So they are going to be taken as loaded into the warehouse. Okay, and whatever coming from unused one is need to be maintained the master copy, right? So master copy will have everything, because it's in daily created files. It's going to be file replaced. It's not appended data. It's now delete and recreate the file. Okay, in this file. So what is going to happen is, we are collecting every record, right? So both the flows from which is coming from replicate, and all this, all the unused one as well, right? So we are going to maintain the proper file. Now, the replicate, will we will have a replicate, and the whatever come is going into the database, we are going to maintain the master copy as well. So this is one solution, and this too can work, you know, most of the cases. So what happens, this is a problem over here. So in first solution, what is the problem? We have a huge dimension table, or we don't want to load the data on daily basis. In the second solution, there is another problem, which is, what if, you know, any records rejected while loading into the database, maybe because of referential integrity constraint, or, you know, unique key constraint, or maybe primary key constraint, or maybe the data issues, or many more, right? As you know. So what is going to happen is, those records is getting rejected, and our master copy will be maintaining those records, and in the database, those records are not there at all, or maybe the update are not there. Database. So in that case, what we need to do is, we have to refine our master file copy, or we need to operate both these records, right, which are rejected from the database, and master copy these records, right, which we are saying that it is a master copy, right? So we need to operate you know, between those two data sets, right? And we need to discard those records from master copy as well. So how we are going to do that, let's see in the following case. And so see the next this diagram. So let me enlarge it a bit. I could make it more visible to you. So what is going to happen is, this is also a small structure, and what we are going to do is, all the reject record we are going to take it, and also the master copy we are going to take, and we are going to join those record, and whichever records are matched record, you know, with that, those 10 record or whatever record which are coming in from the reject port are going to be discarded, you know, they are going to be matched, and exact match will be coming from the output port and will be trashed out. Okay, and whatever is there in unused one will be considered as a master copy. Okay, so this is the about the solution. Okay, so this piece of solution maybe can fit into your requirement, or maybe fit into the, you know, larger schema of data warehousing application or a database application. Okay, so yeah, employ your you know, ab initio or design capabilities or logical capabilities at most to refine and, you know, and design the, you know, optimal solution. Okay, yeah, so with that, thank you so much. Please subscribe my channel, and maybe you can be sharing this channel with your non friends and, you know, other colleagues who may be needing this piece of information. Okay, thank you so much.